Hey guys, Keely Reason here, owner of Love Hub Adventure, where I blog about the marriage relationship, intimacy of marriage, and how you can go deeper with your spouse. And today I'm talking about a couple of tips to help you swallow after you give your husband oral sex. So some wives really want to be able to swallow their husband's semen, but it's tough. It can be kind of difficult, especially if you have a gag reflex that is very sensitive. Maybe you've got a mental block. Maybe, you know, you're just not sure what to do, what it's going to taste like, whatever. And so there's some part of you that is struggling. So here's a couple of tips for you. Number one, the way to kind of start acclimating yourself to the taste, texture, or whatever else with semen is to hold it in your mouth. So after you give your husband oral sex, before you figure out what to do with that, if you're not gonna swallow it, whether you're spitting it out or using a tissue or something, just let it stay in your mouth for longer than you normally would. Allow yourself to come accustomed to the texture, the flavor, the taste, whatever that is. Let it sit there. So just start by kind of acclimating yourself to that. The next tip that I have is to fill your mouth with saliva before you swallow. Just like if you were going to swallow a pill or something else that your throat would naturally try to close up on, you would want to fill your mouth with saliva. If you can't fill your mouth with saliva, maybe you keep some water or something by your bed to help you to get that down. Now, you need to communicate to your spouse that you're doing all of this for them and that this is not some sort of slam against them, but that this is where you have to start. Anything that, you know, if you were taking a pill or swallowing something that is a little tough to swallow, you'd probably have a little drink. Doesn't mean you will always have to have water, but this might be a good way for you to get started on that. The next thing is if your gag reflex is really very sensitive, you can start to work towards desensitizing it to some degree. You do that when you're brushing your teeth. The easiest way to get back to your gag reflex with your toothbrush isn't to go straight down the middle, but it's to run your finger, your toothbrush, whatever it is, along the side of your cheek, and then find a way to get further back. Going straight down the middle is gonna cause you to puke right away. But if you take your toothbrush or take something and run it that way, you can actually start training your gag reflex to relax a little bit. You can also just tell yourself, I need to relax. A lot of self-talk during this will be very helpful. I can do this. I want to do this. I can swallow this. I can be sexy for my spouse. Whatever kind of self-talk that is positive and helps you with it, that's really helpful. I know it can be difficult. So some women, they'll write into me and tell me, well, I don't like the flavor. I don't like the taste. I'm really struggling with this. There is some idea that you can change the flavor of semen. I wouldn't personally focus on that because that is like a huge commitment of what your husband should be eating all the time, and it may or may not work for them. So what I would focus on is just figuring out how you can do this for them on your own based on what the texture and flavor is right now. You can kind of mask that flavor just a little bit. If you're using something like coconut oil or a flavored lube, something else, you know, if you were to put that on your husband before you began oral sex, then you would have some of that flavor. Some people actually do that to make it more enjoyable for them, or maybe, I don't know, some other thing. I mean, I think some people might use chocolate syrup or whatever. This is going to truly be dependent upon how messy you want it to be. And you could always add more when your husband's ready, right before he's ready to orgasm, to help with that flavor as well. So those are a few of my tips for you. I know it's tough, and don't be discouraged or disappointed in yourself if you can't get there, or if you can't get there without trying for a long time. Explain to your spouse what you're trying to do for them And any amount of headway that you get on this, they will be appreciative. Thanks so much for joining me today. Make sure you sign up for my newsletter, lovehubadventure.com/newsletter. I'll send you my free sexy truth or dare bedroom game. I'll link up to that here in the video description. And also be sure to check out the other things that I write about on lovehubadventure.com. Thanks so much for joining me, and I look forward to chatting with you later.